Greetings, noble knights. Last episode focused on Shane and Espada's backstories. Today, I'll continue on with other members of the Crusaders. Let's move on to the backstories of Ruri, Nia, and Sieg. Ruri is usually perky and happy, even when she attacks. But there's more to her than meets the eye. She was raised in an orphanage in the slums with her younger sister. Maybe it was their poor living conditions, but her sister was pretty sickly. Ruri became a bounty hunter to pay for her sister's treatments. Early on, she wasn't a very good bounty hunter, and she didn't make much money. Ruri was doing all she could to prevent her sister's health from deteriorating even further when Ruri learned of Joker's existence. A notorious con man, she discovered there was a huge bounty on him. Wanting to claim the bounty, Ruri started tracking Joker. She made a back alley deal for some intel on him, and started searching all the casinos to find him. She eventually found Joker in one of the casinos and managed to capture him after a long chase. With the reward, Ruri was able to afford proper treatment for her sister, who made a full recovery. She donated the rest of the money to the orphanage where she grew up. You guys probably thought she was just cute, but I think she's pretty mature and responsible. Later on, after Joker used magic to break out of jail, he mentioned she was brave. When news got out that she had captured Joker, the Crusaders asked her to join them. She happily accepted their invitation and became a member of the Crusaders. Here's a fun fact. The person who built the gun Ruri uses was none other than Nia. Nia and Ruri grew up in the same orphanage. Knowing her predicament, Nia built the gun and gave it to Ruri as a gift. Nia was also just your average, everyday girl. But after the lunar eclipse, she became a genius overnight. After that, as long as she had the materials, she could build anything she wanted. One day, she gathered a bunch of materials and built something. It was her trusty sidekick, Bolt. That's when they became the best friends we now know them as. There was a sad story about Bolt being unable to play with her when it rained because of rust, so Nia continued to tinker with and make improvements on Bolt. Then one day, a magician was passing through the slums and saw the state Bolt was in and offered to help. Nia accepted the magician's help, and he implanted a magic gem in Bolt's chest for increased strength. The duo ended up joining the Crusaders on Ruri's recommendation. That's how the Crusaders came to be made up of the most beautiful heroes in Seven Knights. Now the lone male member of the Crusaders is Sieg. He's a skilled swordsman capable of taming the great blade he wields. But because he's more physical than intellectual, the other Crusaders tend to look down on him. Bleh. If you take a look at the affinity chart, Shane, Espada, Nia, and even Ruri, all of them think he's all brawn and no brain. But they're just messing with him, right? Well, let's just say he's on the receiving end of all the affection from the ladies of the Crusaders. How about that? And to be honest, Sieg is a little dense and blunt, but he actually has a lot of common sense and is quite thoughtful. Even after saving Shane, he was apologetic because he didn't get there fast enough, but he didn't want her to feel bad, so he exaggerated to distract her. When Espada was feeling troubled, Sieg was there for her. On top of everything, if you look how Ruri has subtly revealed her feelings, then it's obvious that there's more to him than his dumb charm, right? After learning that Karin had absorbed the power of destruction, the Crusaders followed suit. As a result, they became awakened heroes. Now, of course, they did all of this with the goal of eliminating demons. After Nia awakened, Bolt was affected by the power of destruction and came to life. At Bolt's behest, Nia rebuilt her robot friend. Bolt looks all spiffy now! After Ruri awakened, she was able to wield the power of destruction properly with the gear that Nia built her. The results! She has eyesight far beyond the limits of mere mortals. Thanks to that, she never loses sight of her target. What do you think happened to Sieg? After he awakened, his rather rebellious sword started heeding his commands. Want to check out Sieg's skills now that he's able to fully control his sword? Maybe it's because each member has a unique story to tell. But out of all the different factions within the world of Seven Knights, the Crusaders seem to be the most close-knit. So even though they aren't the main characters of the Seven Knights narrative, a lot of people still seem to like them. I'll be back next time with more fun stories to tell. If you want to check out more stories about the world of Seven Knights, be sure to subscribe. See you next time!